Now, my next guest is a stand-up comic from Ireland who's been making big waves over here, over there, and now over here. John Lynn is in the house. Everybody, John Lynn.
Great to meet you, John.
How you doing?
Good, good.
Have a seat. Now, I need to clear something up, first of all, straight off the bat. Your show is called Social Not Working. Mm-hmm. So, obviously, it's about social networking.
Absolutely not.
No. Why would it be?
Yeah. Why would it be? I just saw that E and it really tantalised me to change it to an O. But it's nonsensical rubbish, really, no. It's about alienation and being isolated and stuff. And you'll see why that is as this interview progresses, why that would happen to me.
It's starting to sound a little bit deep.
It's very deep, yeah. Okay. It's a blend of, you know, Taoism, Zen philosophy, Descartes. Okay. No, it's rubbish. It's all nonsensical.
I was going to say for a minute I was flapping internally.
Yeah, so
questions
was I.
Questions on Descartes, come on.
We flapped together, though. It was a synchronised flapping.
It was. It's about big life changes, right?
Yeah.
That you've had.
Yeah.
Okay.
Kind of, I was a teacher and I tutored in universities, English Lit, and with a long-term girlfriend, and then I ditched all of that to pursue this and debase myself chasing women. Oh, absolutely. I ask myself that every rejection. I really do, Nick. But
those two things, teaching and then comedy, they're both things that people do almost as a calling, maybe. Is that fair?
Yeah. That's what I kind of go on about in the show.
Okay.
But I had a big problem when it came to teaching in that ultimately I had an allergy. And it was you know, minor at first, but it grew. Mm-hmm. It was an allergy to children. And that became a bit of a problem and things.
It doesn't bother all teachers, that allergy. I've seen some that just plow on through.
Yeah, they
just
do.
Just let the hate grow.
Yeah, they do. And it can have a lovely payoff in the end. Tantric hating, you know.
Tantric hating.
Yeah,
nice.
Yeah. Just let it build up eventually. But
Have you ever missed teaching since you left?
Yeah, occasionally when I was been evicted from somewhere due to having no money. But that was, and that was only fleeting because then I thought, the street's all right, you know. It was the summer and there's very few kids out there because
that's right.
Social services, they pick them up, you know. But I did enjoy teaching. And I think doing stand-up teaching is actually a great, because you're talking to people who kind of hate you the minute you stand up there, so you have to kind of win them over. You know, when you're starting stand-up gigs, the only gigs you can get are on the back boozers, where as soon as you stand up, before you even get to the mic, people are screaming that you're shit, you know, and that was very similar to teaching Shakespeare and stuff, you know.
And how is your generic Edinburgh performer question? How's your Edinburgh this year?
It's going well. It's going really well so far. Yeah, it's selling really well. Well, my kid's sister's over flying with me, so
that's nice.
As far as I know, they're not ditching them in the bin, you know, which could have been the case otherwise.
Yeah, you don't want that.
No, they're selling it big style, yeah, because my old man is petrified that I'll remain on the streets, you know. I catch him occasionally at Sunday dinner just staring at me, you know, that real kind of like, you're gonna starve.
I paid for your
time. Yeah. So I think he sent them over as kind of sleepers, you know, to try and you have to help your brother. He's talentless and deranged. And so it's selling really well and going very well.
Brilliant.
So yeah.
Well, we know your show's going great. We're going to check out what other people around about Edinburgh are recommending.
Okay.
We've got a little VT. This is some Vox Populi. The Talking Heads of Edinburgh. Here's what they're checking out at the moment of the festival.
I would recommend going to see Sam Simmons. He's a really brilliant Australian comic and he does really surreal joke. I mean, it's a multimedia show, but I find it really funny. And you look at it and you think it's this kind of surreal, absurdist mess, but he's such a craftsman and he brings it all together really nicely. I really love Tony Law. He's another good one. He's a brilliant stand-up.
my favourite acts of the festival this year are McNeil and Pamphlon, just at the Pleasant Stone. Also, Reagans look real enough. I think they're at the Assembly Garden. And also, who else have I seen? The Pink Noise, they're called Fork. They do covers of like rock and pop songs. Quite amazing show to watch this year at the festival.
At the moment, for me, my favourite show is Theatre of Widdershins. They do a wonderful kids puppet show called The King's Got Donkey's Ears. Absolutely phenomenal.
Personally, my favourite show at the Fringe so far is Matt Ricardo, Three Balls and a New Suit, at the Voodoo Rooms, because he is a sensational juggler.
He is rather good.
He's off the charts, spiffing.
For me, I have to say it has to be Sam Simmons. Meanwhile, brilliant. It's just completely surreal, but there's actually a story running through it, and it's just off the wall. And if you're wondering why he's smashing tacos into his chest, it'll all make sense. It's a brilliant show, and I'd highly recommend it.
Sam Simmons is my hot pick, I'd say. He's, without a doubt, the most surreal guy at the festival. Another one to check out is Michael Wortman, probably the most beautiful comedy show I've seen. So definitely two hot picks. Gilda Balloon, check him out.
That's What's Hot, and I wasn't even on there. Sam Simmons obviously making a big noise in Edinburgh. Have we got Sam Simmons coming on the show? No, he's not, no. Have you seen Sam Simmons' show?
I haven't, because he's on at the same time as me.
Okay.
Well, very close. No, he's on at 9:15. But I did have a few pints with him in the Laugh Bar, and he's a very strange man. Very strange.
So it's actually what you see on stage is mirrored off stage.
Let's just put it, I'm extraordinarily tight, and it was his round, and I decided I'd head off. You know, that's...
Wow.
It's a pretty big one. It's a pretty big one. People who know me there, because you hear the gasps of surprise there. They're going, that guy must be a psychotic.